Well, it certainly looked menacing for a minute when you had those big snowflakes falling at such a heavy rate, and it seemed like we were about in for a decent snowfall. But the bark, again, in this case, much worse than the bite, but the timing just wasn't the best, right? Here's a look at all that's left of the snow from earlier. It has virtually ended for almost everyone in the tri-state, with the exception of our neighbors down here across parts of Brown and Adams County. Still some hefty snow falling Georgetown over towards Macon, Seaman, Peebles. And some of these communities, you could pick up a quick quarter to a half an inch, but it turns over to plain rain once you get south of the Ohio River. Williamstown, Falmouth, over towards Lenoxburg, even over towards Maysville, it looks like a little rain will be mixing in. This is the end of this snow event, and looks like the last for a while as we should begin to warm up from here. Hey, look what we were able to capture out in Mount Auburn. We've got a nice little snow fight going, snowball fight going here this evening. You can see some of the big snowballs flying around. Let me take you around the tri-state, check out some of the road conditions, and see how conditions are faring up. For example, take you over to around Hebron right now, and you can see the roadways just simply wet, looking pretty good in most locations at this time. Take you down, for example, over towards Villa Hills, Erlanger, roadways here simply wet. Move you up north towards Sharonville. You can see this is 75. Just simply wet, the roadways all in good shape, and then take you to around the 75, near the Lachlan split here, and you can see traffic moving pretty good. So all in all, while the evening commute started out a little rough, with temperatures hovering at or just above freezing, we're at 34. Certainly anything that the road crews are putting down in terms of salt, very effective out there. And we don't have to worry about black ice for a while, because look at our temperatures here through the evening. We'll actually begin to continue creep up a couple of degrees. So with temperatures staying at or above freezing for most of the evening before midnight, you don't have to worry about any real slick conditions out there, as any snow that fell is going to melt, at least on paved surfaces. So this is the last in what's been a series of quick hitting clippers. They're known for producing a couple of inches of snow, usually within a several hours time frame. This one no exception, and you can already see skies are beginning to clear out across parts of Indiana and Illinois tonight. Look at our temperatures, 32 in Wilmington, 33 Georgetown, 35 in Mace. Well, that's why you're mixing with rain there. Vivi at 35, even Aurora at 36, and Versailles at 35. So our winds are out of the southwest, so it's a warm direction. So as I mentioned, through the evening, temperatures will probably tick their way up a couple of degrees, so we don't have to really be overly concerned about black ice until after midnight. Looks like after midnight, those temperatures will head back down into the 20s, and then highs tomorrow will climb their way into the mid-30s, but look down here to our south, 40s and 50s, not far away. It's been a while since I've been able to say that. So that is coming in here for later on this week. So futurecast shows that pretty much everything's done. There may be some spits of drizzle out there, but that's generally about it. And it looks quiet heading into your Tuesday and Wednesday. Here's your day planner. 24 at 7 o'clock tomorrow morning, 27 by 10, 33 by lunchtime. We should top out around 36. So the snow has ended for most of us. Expect mostly cloudy skies overnight. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy. There could be a stray flurry or two. No big deal. Here's your 7-day forecast. How about we're back into the 40s by Thursday?